know, this is a big step for him. You look at the records of these two guys and you think he should pull over Kamil Odom, but Odom's been in with a very tough competition, and this is, I think it's really an odds might for the approval bidding, man, which I know neither of us are. This would be an even fight.
Henry Kinawande is the young man that has fought the last two times against Scholes. First time a 12-round draw for the European Championship, and the next time it was a win by Kinawande from England. So the last outing for Scholes, not a good one, as he lost his last fight, losing in 12 rounds on May 1st.
He wasn't embarrassed at all in the fight. Akwandani, picked up fighters, was a solid fighter, unbeaten with a knockout ratio. So the fact that Scholes went 24 rounds with him in two bouts, it certainly didn't hurt him by any means. And you know, being on the fringe of heavyweight champion of Europe, being that close, he's no embarrassed.
Very nice young man. Had a chance to visit with him at the weigh-in as he gets a pretty good right hand on an Odom that bounces him off the ropes. Speaks English very well, understands our language, and is going to make himself very much at home here in the United States as he too tries to climb up that heavyweight ladder. 15-1-1 record, 8 by knockouts, 15-10, 10-11 knockouts by Odom. Think about it, he sets up so much with his jab, and he double triples the jab as well. Just continuing to try to loosen you up. That was a pretty good left hook, as you heard that one. This is a little bit of an uncharacteristic European style, Bob. Most of the time it's very upright, very straight, but as you said, he crouches down low, hides peekaboos behind the gloves. Good looking style for the young man from Germany. Ed Cotton, a very tall gentleman himself. Keep in mind that Scholes is 6'4", Odom is 6'2", almost looks to be taller than two, so that may not be totally accurate from the numbers we got. They both look about the same height. Ed Cotton is taller than either one of them, our referee. Closing seconds of round number one, neither fighter really taking a big advantage, even though you can see the German champion is starting to get a little bit more of his advantage here near the end of the first round of a scheduled 10-rounder. Both fighters trying to find their comfort zone in round number one. Axel Scholes, again, his entourage has been in the country for about a week up in New York and then down here in New Jersey. For Odom, who does not use a stool, by the way. It is there, but he's elected not to use it. He's 22 years of age across the way. And the German champion. And he's got some pretty good punches. Pretty good right hand right there, Bob. As Odom continues to stand before the start of the second round. Seconds are out, and they get ready to rumble for three more rounds here in our heavyweight explosion from Atlantic City. Round number two is underway. Axel Scholes in the black, the German heavyweight champion against Kimmel Odom from Gary, Indiana. A consummate opponent as of late, a young man that had a brilliant start to his career, losses to Ray Mercer for the IBF Intercontinental title in March of 1990, lost in 12 tough rounds to Ray Mercer. KO'd by Razor Ruddock in the third. Pierre Kutcher, the once South African heavyweight, also got a knockout. That came in the 10th round. Also lost to Bone Crusher Smith in the third round, Tony Tucker in the second, and Tommy Morrison also was defeating by a knockout in the third round. So he's been in there with some very good names in the heavyweight division. Scholes being warned to keep his punches up here in round two.
What he looks like here, actually, it really felt like I've trained for this fight. I've been down in North Carolina for all the kind of things that I've never done before in preparation for this fight. I'm kind of heavy. Yeah.
the second round and certainly gets the crowd involved in it. One of the other fighters from over in Europe, Zeljko Mavrović, also fought on this card. Very quick heavyweight. And now you're seeing the quickness also here from Axel Schultz. John Taylor, who is the trainer for Odom, is working in the corner over there along with Goody Petronelli out of Brockton, Mass. So a pretty good brain trust will certainly tell him what he must try to do in the third round when they take the respite. He's trying to hook that left hand and he's got a pretty good weapon, but I tell you what, he throws both of them with authority. The German comes in and pounds away on Odom. You see the time winding down as they fought 2-10 here in the heavyweight explosion. Time. An exchange right at the end of the second round sends both fighters heading to their stools, but in the case of Odom, he elects not to take the stool here in the first couple of rounds. As again, a good look at him, and that, of course, is John Taylor working with him along with Goody Petronelli outside the ropes. Themselves and get back up again. Odom, a fighter at several of the Gary and Chicago amateur titles. And as a matter of fact, competed in the Olympic trials at one time. While this young man had a very illustrious amateur career, we'll allude to coming up in just a moment. Very intently listening to his instructions. As again, he handed the right hand that just missed its mark, came in with a left hand that caught him on the laces. And he does throw some punches and combinations, does the German champion. This is round number three of a 10-round heavyweight fight from Atlantic City's Resorts International. Sam Smith along with Bob Spagnuolo. And the German champion in the black with his back to you is Axel Schultz against Camille Odom from Gary, Indiana. You know, Bob, one of the measurements that we got at the weigh-in yesterday, and it's a little bit of surprising to me, at 6'4", Axel Schultz only has a 75-inch reach for a heavyweight, 81 for Odom. So that's the reason he has that crashing get-inside style, because he's got to get there because of that lack of reach that he fights most of the heavyweights with.
Good, solid inside body shots and left hooks to the jaw. And Odom kind of throwing some pity-pat punches here, but they're all just range fights.
By the way, if Sylvester Stallone had not found an opponent like Tommy Morrison to fight, and of course the other people that he fought in some of the fights, this guy would have been a good European guy to get in the movies as well, wouldn't he?
He would. And he's coming to fight. You know, he's got a lot of people coming over here.
Now they'd love nothing more than to get another world title. Of course, they already have one. Henry Maska is the light heavyweight champion at one time, knocking off Prince Charles Williams. And we'll have a tough defense of that title coming up very shortly over in Dusseldorf, Germany. By the way, this fight is being televised live back to Germany. They have sent a cast of thousands down to broadcast this thing, as they've got announcers running all over the place getting ready for this fight. And they're very, very proud of this young man, and rightly so. He's earned his place among some of the great sports stars over in Germany, and the future is very bright as we near the end of round three.
Good work in there on the inside.
Camille Olam trying to get the crowd boosted up in his favor. Axel Schultz is doing all he needs to do in the 3 minutes of fighting that he's had, Albert. And he's done an excellent job of, as you pointed out, his landing punches from a lot of areas. Take a little early shower here. Also had good balance after he threw that first combination under balance to be able to come right back with another punch or two. And Odom's let his guard drop. He did not. And after three, the German champion continues to fight well against the American. Well, I'm sure as this fight progresses, as we move into round four of a scheduled 10 round, the patriotism of this American crowd is going to start showing. But Odom has to help him out a little bit. He's got to start landing some punches on the German heavyweight champion, Schultz.
You can see Camille continue every round. He starts and tries to establish his jab, get some distance in between the Schultz and Schultz on the other hand. The crowd is, Camille's trying to fight him on the inside. Those long arms, it's a little bit hard on him. He's going to split up in front of Schultz. Schultz is catching with a good right hand and a left hand to the side.
Well, I tell you what, that left jab is like a lightning bolt. It just kind of sneaks in there on you real quick.
Yeah, that's like, it's like a lightning jab. You know, the danger in this fight for Axel Schultz will be when he deals with fatigue for the first time, when he starts standing on the outside with Camille Odom and not pressing. This leg right here, giving Odom an opportunity to maybe drop that big right hand. That's what Camille Odom wants to do. Wants to get his range. He's got to be right hand.
They said, by the way, that was one of the problems against Akinduwande, is the fact that he went 12 and got a draw. He went 12 and lost. He'd also gone 10 rounds just two fights earlier. So he's gone a lot of distance. But again, fatigue set in, particularly in the draw that he had in the first fight with Akinduwande.
Sure, let it all hang out here. I've got to win the first three rounds. He's making the fight. Odom keeps trying to find a spot to get involved in this thing. And right here, you can see that Odom's trying to work on the inside. Got those long arms and that long kind of a rhythm fighter that Camille Odom is. He's not as apt at fighting on the inside as actually Schultz is. And probably would have never expected a European heavyweight to be able to work the inside like that.
I think he almost expected the normal European champion to be kind of straight up, but it's not. He's like a boring in style, and it's tough for Odom to try to get anything in. By the way, we mentioned John Taylor, along with Goody Petronelli, working in the corner of Odom. Pretty good people over in the Germans' corner as well. Manfred Volke, who was the 1968 Olympic welterweight champion of the Olympics down in Mexico City, is the trainer. And Darkie Smith, also well-renowned with his training in Europe, are working the corner of the German here tonight. So brain trust on both sides. They are dissecting each round to try to give their man the upper hand.
Good solid boxing by Axel Schultz here. He parried and picked off several of the punches of Camille Odom and landed some clean shots of his own.
Schultz again bearing in. Schultz at 216 pounds, 239 for Odom.
Camille's sitting here hesitant to pull the trigger. He's got to put those range finders in there. He can't just rely on one shot for this guy. Schultz here backs into the ropes. Where he wants it to be chest to chest, and then he digs down and gets some range in between.
Well, as Odom goes to the corner again, not using the stool as he has stood this entire time in between each of the rounds. Again, he has taken a pretty good pounding here by the German heavyweight champion, Axel Schultz. Dished out some pretty good punishment, at least at the early stages of round number four, but could not maintain the pace as the German pretty well had his own near the end of round number four. Odom was one of those guys, though, Bob, when you take a look at the record of the people he's had to fight, that always had that dangerous one punch, and everybody had the theory, of course, he did take some punishment. Certainly lost in a 10-round knockout to Pierre Kutzer, the young man from South Africa.
A lot of big losses were conditioning. He got, you know, in those later rounds with a good fight, didn't have the conditioning.
There's a look, by the way, at Axel Schultz's wife. Excuse me, that's his fiance. Not married yet. I almost got him married too quickly. That is his fiance. This is round number five as Axel Schultz, once again the German heavyweight champion, in the black to the right, fighting Camille Odom from the United States in Gary, Indiana. Amateur record, a very good one for Odom. Several Gary and Chicago, Illinois titles. Actually owns an amateur win over Mike Tyson when he was fighting back in his early days. Also competed in the Olympic trials. Did not have the opportunity to represent his country, but was there and had a shot.
I'm not so sure about that amateur win over Mike Tyson. All the fighters on Tyson in the unit. He would have lost a lot of amateur.
Matter of fact, there were three of them on this card that said they had. But keep in mind, there are two Mike Tysons, so that's we just kind of throw that out for food for thought, right? By the way, Odom did beat, he beat Mike Tyson, a TKO in the third, but it was the other Mike Tyson. Yes, it was.
So, good job here. It's been impressive for me this fall, Sammy. His conditioning in the later rounds is going to mean a lot. He's kicking the crap out of Camille Odom at this stage of the fight, and it's not because Camille didn't have time to prepare or took the fight on short notice. He's had all the time. He's had training camp. And, he's really tough to fight, this guy, and I think he's a little surprised with the competitiveness.
Schultz just kind of brawling into the corner right now. Schultz didn't start fighting till the age of 11, which I don't guess is that totally uncharacteristic. Nonetheless, he's come on very strongly at only 24 with already 17 fights under his belt and 15 wins. Also won 78 of his 98 amateur fights. Was the 1982 youth champion in East Germany. Also went on as a three-time East German junior champion. 88, he was a senior champion. 89, runner-up for the European senior championship title.
Now here at this stage of the fight, you can see that Schultz is not, he's not smothering Odom. He's on the outside, but he's the quicker guy, and he's landing the shots coming in. And Odom does not seize this opportunity to do what he wants to do, which is use this, range that he has from Schultz to drop the big right hand to Odom and find him with the jab and drop the right hand. He's far from over with, but he's been impressive on this point.
Closing seconds of this, the fifth round. Axel Schultz almost slipped as he backpedaled and then threw a big right hand at Odom coming in on top of him. Is setting down on some punches, and again with that shorter reach, 81 to 75, he's got to get on his chest. He's been there most of the evening so far. Good luck at the German heavyweight champion, Axel Schultz. Many people feel that this young man has kind of flattened out in his preparation. He had gone to such heights, as I made mention, of winning several of the European and certainly the German champions. But even though he's at 15-1-1, they don't feel that he's made that many good strides ahead. Of course, the Akawande fights will probably indicate that here's a guy that he went in some very good competition, but they didn't have him excelling as well as they thought he might. So there's a little concern on what he'll do against some good competition so far. Crisp fighting well against Odom, a guy that has been in there with a lot of good champions. So it's a good opportunity to see what he can do here in the States. Seconds whistle down as we get ready to start the sixth. Well, for fans who certainly recognize the world of baseball, it's almost a shutout thrown here so far by Axel Schultz in the black trunks, the German heavyweight champion. Odom has come and taken his swings, but he has so far been shut out by Schultz, who on my card has won virtually every round, and so far on Bob's card as well, unofficially here at ringside. Three judges with the scoring on a 10-point must system. By the way, there is a three knockdown rule if that should be coming in effect later on, and there is a standing eight count if any one of these fighters should be in in trouble, Ed Cotton has the discretion to hold up the fight momentarily, which would be, of course, reflected on the scorecard of the judges.
But here in the sixth round, Schultz is doing, there's distance between these two fighters right now, Sam. But to me, favor Odom in his boxing and his good straight right hand that he uses and that he scored a lot of his knockouts with. But what Schultz is doing here is he's picking the times he wants to fight. He's not backing up. They're walking around, they're parrying each other's punches, and when he wants to exchange punches with Odom, he is. And when not, he's backing up and boxing a little bit. He's really doing a good job.
Very, very good quick feet for a heavyweight. We're talking 216 pounds. Looks with his frame. As a matter of fact, I was just looking at all the other weights. The highest that he's fought under that we have listed here at 219. So this is a very comfortable weight, and you don't anticipate him to put up much more than what he's got right now.
Solid boy.
Odom trying to exchange in the middle of the ring. It's got Schultz for the first time backing up here in the sixth round. That is going to work on him, and you can hear that partisan American crowd coming alive here in Atlantic City. German trying to steal it right back though.
That's right, Kim Il-sung. But look at Kim Il. He's not going to him anymore. That was his opportunity. He let go with a few punches, and now here comes Axel Schultz. Watch him dig downstairs. That's just what he's going to do. He's going to bend to the side and turn some of those hooks. He's in good condition. I thought he was resting a little bit in this round, but when Odom started to come on, he said, I know. I got to establish myself every round with this big guy.
And he's fully cognizant of the fact that, as is the normal case with any kind of boxer, you go to the body, you kill the body, and the head will follow. And certainly that's the case, as Schultz, again, has gone well to the body on Odom with some pretty good headhunting with good straight left and right combinations.
And he's also got to be aware of, regardless of Kim Il-sung's preparation or being in camp or whatever, the guy's been an opponent, and opponents have a tendency to say, oh, this isn't my night, I've been through tough times, and I'm not gonna, it's just a letdown when a guy comes to you like this, and you don't have a tendency to let it all hang out as much when you've had 8 or 9 losses in a professional career. Schultz doesn't want Kim Il-sung to get the thought in his mind, hey, I can win this fight. I've got to win every single round. Schultz is thinking, stop this guy.
Well, Axel Schultz, with a little pump of that right hand, comes back to his stool, feeling confident he's doing exactly what he wants to do. Here's a good look at the plane thrust. That, by the way, is Darkie Smith. Oh, hello. Round number 7. Arky Smith again outside the ropes, and that is Manfred Volke inside. And Arky, well renowned with the people he's had. Volke, of course, a former Olympian champion from East Germany. And that's his brain thrust as they work with in his corner. A little swelling under the left eye they're working on, but nothing to worry about right now. Searching that mark, the German champion. He's hitting with a couple of shots along the way.
He really has. Here we're going to see Odom pressing Schultz for the first time in the fight, puts him on the ropes, unloads combination.
So the best round for Odom has definitely been the sixth round, and as a matter of fact, that earns a draw on our card.
I did call it an even round, but I really felt like at the end of the round, Schultz was back in control of the fight. And
exactly.
Kamille had his chance to take over and win a round, and get the crowd behind him. That was it, and he didn't accomplish that.
What does this do for Odom now? As he comes back out, he had that opportunity, and now it may be gone. What does he do in his mind about coming out and fighting Schultz?
Odom's got to make something happen. The way I've got the fight scored, he hasn't won a round yet, and we've got 4 rounds to go in this fight, and Schultz continues to impress. So, Kamille can't put himself in a position where he's got to get out here and whack this guy out in the last 2 rounds of the fight, because Schultz has already shown himself to be an adaptable fighter with some good defense, and he's not going to go out there and just turn to jello for Kim Il-sung in the last 2 rounds. He's so far ahead that he'd have to get knocked out to win.
Beautiful part of the heavyweight explosion and the heavyweight spirit is that one punch all of a sudden turns a fight totally around. Kim Il-sung tried to find that one punch in the last round. He did have the German backing up, but could not do any further damage to him. Very well conditioned, 6'4", 216 pounds, 24-year-old German. A right hand on Odom's got him in trouble.
Follow with the left, and look at Schultz's work. He's not looking to rest. His conditioning is absolutely no problem. You can tell when a fighter, the way he's fighting in there, that he's not looking to rest. He's looking to put some hurt on Kim Il-sung.
fight seven rounds as they had, and Schultz is not even breathing hard. He has really put in a night's work already. Minute 20 to go, and this is the seventh round.
And although he is backing straight up when he backs up from Oldham, that is a dangerous thing. He's got enough life in his legs, enough movement to take away the shots from Kimmel Oldham, even when he does get in a defensive posture.
By the way, one world champion watching in attendance here today, WBA light heavyweight champion Virgil Hill is looking on, setting over with internationally known boxing promoter Cedric Kushner as they talk about the upcoming fight of Virgil Hill as he defends his title in his hometown of Bismarck, North Dakota, here in this month of August. Yes, Bob, we do get to go to Bismarck, North Dakota again.
Well treated.
Closing seconds of round number seven. Heavyweight explosion has been very well received by these folks here in Atlantic City. And so far, Odom has held his own for the most part against Schultz, but Schultz has definitely had the scoring advantage on the scorecard.
Well, look at Odom. You know, he's backing up in boxing. He's not trying to get this German that's come in the United States out of there. He's almost trying to survive himself. Schultz is, he's gotten back after the first even round of six in this fight, and he's taken back control of this fight.
Good look at 24-year-old Axel Schultz into his corner, another solid 10-9 round as they'll be heading for the eighth round of a scheduled 10 rounder here at Resorts International Casino Hotel.
And here he is on the replay continuing. He lands a good left, a right, parrying left jab, and then a right hand, and comes with a straight left after it. There we see it again, and the left had as much on it as the right hand. Impressive combination by Axel Schultz.
You know, and every time he would land one of those bobs and get in tight, he'd push off to give himself some more punch, and
give
he would go right back to
range. He's really been impressive to me here.
So Odom, who has not been on his stool the entire evening here, it's John Taylor on his left. Goody Petronelli spraying from behind across the way. The German champion is up and ready to go as they prepare themselves for round number eight. A good German contingency has filed in here in Atlantic City at Resorts International, and they try to pump up their German heavyweight champion, Axel Schultz. It really hasn't needed much punching up in this particular fight against Kamille Oldham, as he's come out swinging from the opening bell. Odom just kind of fading in the wind here.
Yeah, Camille he's not showing a tendency right now to try. Oh, the big left hook hurts Odom. I mean, he's not showing a tendency of trying to get back into this fight or trying to be the boss in there. At this stage, he's trying to box and stay away from action. And Schultz, to his credit, man, I mean, if I had a guy that had won, you know, hadn't lost a round in seven, I might pull him off a little bit, but he's doing really the only thing he can do, crowd and pressure this guy, and he's going to do that right on through the end of the fight, and doing a real good job of it.
Which is a compliment to his defense that they can allow him to get in there, and you can see behind that peekaboo style, there's very few of all those big punches have been able to land.
A nice combination of a right uppercut, left hook by Axel Schultz there. Camille is having some real problems with this kid. And look at Schultz use the left hand as a range finder as he backs up to hold him and keep him off. He really is showing himself some nice skills here and a set of quick hands.
You know, just wonder when you're taking a look at a youngster on his way up at 24, I will compare with Lennox Lewis. That could be rather interesting after certainly Schultz gets some more timing under his belt. But of course, the big size of a Reddick Bowe, how a guy like Schultz would be able to stand up with him with that big punching power he possesses. We know he'll be busy. We know he is very active, but can he put another heavyweight away? He's trying to do of Odom right now. A minute to go in round eight.
Odom's always been a very durable guy. I mean, even when you saw him with Razor Ruddock, one of the most devastating punchers, I mean, he was exchanging punches with Ruddock, so finally he got hurt and put out at the end of the third round. But I mean, he's not even exchanging punches with Schultz. He can't hit him. You know, he's sitting here trying different things, and Schultz is picking his shots and really completely dominated the fight. And I honestly believe the difference difference between an Axel Schultz, if he puts together 6 or 7 weeks now, he'll get a shot at the heavyweight championship of the world, and he'll get it at home, because the Germans will get behind him, the television, the sponsors, and he'll get his shot under much better circumstances than a lot of guys at his stage.
Interesting point. 16 seconds as you see it winding down here in round number 8. As the young German has made his first trip to the United States, he's been very impressive against Odom here tonight as part of the heavyweight explosion from Resorts International Casino Hotel in Atlantic City, New Jersey. Odom still trying to encourage the crowd to get on his side, but as you can take a quick look into the corner of Schultz, he is at nothing but a uphill climb as Odom trying to catch up with the kid from Germany. Schultz has battled very well. He's had a lot of weapons. He's thrown the short, straight jabs. He's thrown the good right-left combinations. He had the uppercuts, the hooks. And more than anything, he's kept so much under balance. That's the most impressive part that I've seen from him so far, Bob.
His balance is solid. You know, his defense is good. And he's, you know, as Odom's employed various tactics, Schultz has been able to adapt to them. He really has been impressive. And just, you know, as we talked earlier in the show about the fact that, you know, they were sending him over here to the United States, where he beats Odom.
Well, they get the seconds and the ring card girls out of the ring. And here's the bell. It starts round number 9 and in the center of the ring from Germany. Axel Schultz, their heavyweight champion, against Camille Odom of the United States in the goal. Schultz, who has had this posture virtually the entire round with the exception of the section, who has backed up the ropes, and look at him go to work on Odom again. Pushing away, trying to get even more damage to throw on the American.
A lot of times when you go overseas like this and have a big win like Axel Schultz is having here, he'll be welcomed home with a hero's welcome and really completely reestablish himself as not only the heavyweight champion of Germany, but a future contender.
A warning for holding on Schultz. Something that he definitely doesn't need to do, that's for sure.
You don't want to wrestle with Odom.
No.
You know, Odom grabs him and he pulls right away.
Well, I tell you, there's one thing about Schultz, when you look at him straight on, there's such concentration in those eyes. He's so focused. But one speed, and that is full bore. Has not backed up, the exception of once in this crowd. By the way, you heard Axel Schultz fans open up the 8th round. You heard the USA chant open up round number 9, trying to get Odom into this fight.
Schultz has not moved it at all here in this place. I think that's very impressive. You know, your level of competition, you can only be as good as they are. And, you know, to come over here, Emil Odom's obviously employed a tactic of, you know, getting into the later rounds, and this guy slows down and then try to unload some heavy artillery on him, but thus far he hasn't slowed down, so he hasn't made himself an available target at all.
Schultz again trying to get his 16th victory against a single loss, absorbing that loss the last time out. Henry Anakawande, the young man from England, picked up the European Boxing Championship for the heavyweights in a 12-round decision win. The only loss that this man has felt as a pro. That came after a draw between the two earlier. You can see Odom trying to exchange here.
Yeah, he landed a good right hand, but Schultz is pressing him and trying to keep that distance short. He knows, you know, this is the danger spot in this fight for him. You see Odom trying to rough him up, trying to wrestle him, trying to lean on him. Obviously, he's a bigger man.
Closing half minute of the 9th round, it appears that we will go the full distance in this heavyweight fight. There's always that chance that it can end on one punch. So far, Schultz has been throwing punches in bunches. But Odom has maintained his composure to stay in this fight anyway. Well back on the cards, we'll have to probably pull out all the stops as he heads for round 10 after a 1 minute rest by both of these heavyweights here in Atlantic City. Very tired Odom goes one way, and a very invigorated German champion Axel Schultz goes the other way. Again, he has spent his time and his rest period on the stool. While Odom has stood most of the time for him, as a matter of fact, the entire fight. And no mark marks on the German champion as of yet. And a little worry about a little swelling under the left eye. No problem there. You see Darkie Smith working on that. He's also going under the right eye. Otherwise, unmarked for this man. On the other side, Odom also unmarked. No bleeding or cuts that he's had to sustain tonight. And Schultz is not going to get punches at him. Some world championships. Getting ready for the 10th. Well, they touch gloves. This will be the final round of this 10th rounder. Odom comes out slinging leather, and he was quickly answered by Axel Schultz.
Schultz isn't even going to let Jim L. Odom think about coming trying out here and finish this guy. And I'm sure that's what John Taylor calls Jim L. You got to get this guy out of here, son.
Schultz again sticking a left jab and then following it for the most part with good right hands. Odom throwing some combinations, but just no steam on him right now. The tape coming loose on the left glove of Odom may stop a little action here momentarily in a moment. Now they do. So apparently they have seen it, and the glove on that left hand is coming loose. Odom goes one way, they'll just simply cut that off, I believe, because they have the duct tape, which is the gray tape you see on the glove, holding down the tape, but one end of it just came loose. Now we're back to action here in round number 10.
And you can see in John, the expression in John Taylor's face when he reminded Camille Odom, hey, oh, and there's a big combination by Schultz.
Odom's is going down, somehow the ropes have maintained a chance to keep him up. The referee could have easily given a standing eight count right there. Odom's
in
real
trouble. Schultz, this would be a heck of an exclamation point for him to put on his fight. He's got Kimura Odom in all kinds of trouble.
German champion, an uppercut, a right hand, another one. This could be another standing eight count. It's not called by Ed Cotton. Well, he's given Odom every benefit of the doubt because his ropes have held him up twice.
That's right, and that's supposed to be the call for the standing eight. Schultz is certainly putting an exclamation point onto this fight here in the 10th round, Sam.
Odom trying to hold to keep more damage from coming his way. Boy, has the German exploded in round 10.
He made himself some friends here in Atlantic City today.
Now this crowd that has certainly enjoyed the heavyweight explosion, getting a taste of it here from an international flavor.
Excellent fight, excellent matchup here on our heavyweight explosion.
Odom has been a game competitor. He just hasn't had the skill to match that of Schultz. And always with a heavyweight, one punch turns it around, but that one punch never materialized today for Odom outside of a very good middle of the sixth round. That was when he had the German in trouble, but could not finish him off. Couldn't get him in any further trouble.
Schultz has demonstrated that that hand speed that he has, he just doesn't have it in the first couple of rounds of the fight. He's had it throughout the fight. That's a very valuable tool for a heavyweight. Odom has nothing right now.
Trying to throw punches, just trying to keep it legit here. Ed Cotton, by the way, on that break, looked very much into the eyes of Odom to see if he was okay. Late to do that after those two possible standing eights that were not called. But it has been a big 10th round again by the German Axel Schultz. Bright future for this 24-year-old. He's got the speed, the quickness, possibly the power in the hands as he's shown here in the 10th round as he again, backs Odom back up in the ropes, and somehow, once he got Velcro on his back, he continues to stay up as you see the closing seconds of the 10th round, and this one is over. So this crowd has been entertained, first of all, from a German invasion of this man, Axel Schultz, the German heavyweight champion, has come and shown his skills. Quickness, speed, hand power, and Odom has put on a pretty good show also to stay in the fight with Schultz as well. And the crowd very appreciative of what they've seen here in the heavyweight explosion tonight. It was interesting to see how Schultz was going to react to his first trip to America. Look how well he's still throwing combinations. This was the first time he got Odom in trouble on the ropes. I mean, the ropes clearly keep him up. And then Schultz just really pounds away, and Odom is nearly out on his feet right there. Was able to get his gloves back up, which was a good sign.
Schultz really showed some good, even though he didn't finish him, he showed some good attempts at it. They've got to be very proud. They're over there giving the German.
Well, we have the decision, and it's going to be a quick one. Let's go up to ring announcer Ed Darien.
Ladies and gentlemen, from the beautiful Coconut Ballroom here at Merv Griffin's Resorts Casino Hotel in Atlantic City, New Jersey, we've got the decision, and here it is. Judges John Riley and Deborah Barnes each score 97-93, while Judge John Stewart, he watched it at 99-91. For the winner, by unanimous decision, the heavyweight champion of Germany, Axel Scholz.
Well, two of the judges scoring it a little closer than even we thought it would be at 97-93, but John Stewart seeing it 99-91, pretty much close to what we had on our scorecard, as the German champion, along with Kamil Odom, celebrate in the center of the ring as they put on quite a fight here in our heavyweight explosion. But it comes away to the German champion going 16-1-1 and very much on the upswing in the heavyweight division.